Okay, so today is Tuesday, which means it's time for In the Kitchen. So we are getting a little lesson inside Brew Dr. Kombucha. Some plans for some great summer refreshing drinks. Cassidy Quinn is there live in Southeast Portland with some of those ideas. Cassidy.
Guys, I don't know if you know what kombucha is. You've probably tasted it before if you're sitting at home wondering what it is. We're going to find out in just a minute. But first, I will say, I actually started making my own kombucha in the last month. That does not mean that I know anything about it or what I am actually doing. And that is why we have Matt, the founder and CEO of Brew Dr. Kombucha, with very professionally made kombucha in front of us. So many different flavors. Mine is still just like the one flavor that I started it out as. So I'll ask you later, you know, how I deal with that. But you guys have actually some spring flavors, right?
Yeah, well, you got to start somewhere, so good for you for making it home. We have 11 different varieties. We're just showcasing some here today. Launching right now is this new mint lemonade, which is just a really approachable mix, something that people who might be new to kombucha can walk up to the shelf and say, oh, that tastes good, and sure enough, it is.
Now, a lot of people are new to kombucha, so if they don't know what it is, if they see it on the shelf, what actually is it?
So kombucha is a tea product, right? And Townsend's was a tea company first before we started making kombucha. And that's, I think, one of the reasons why our kombucha is more approachable. So you take tea, you sweeten it with cane sugar, and then you ferment it for about 2 weeks. And during that fermentation process, it creates a host of probiotics. So live and active cultures that populate the gut and detoxify the system. Really good for the immune boost and just proper digestive health.
Now, in the winter, when it's cold out, you drink warm tea, and then maybe the spring and the summer, cold kombucha is a better idea?
Well, kombucha is becoming a year-round beverage because so much of the health community is waking up to the importance of gut health that it's almost being prescribed as like a daily probiotic multivitamin, and it's a tasty way to get that.
And one other thing people might be scared away from is you always hear, oh, kombucha has alcohol in it. You can't have it if you're a kid. You can't have it if you're going to work. That is not true, especially in this case.
Well, sure. I mean, kombucha you make at home probably has 1-2% alcohol in it. We don't shy away from that. We make kombucha in an authentic way that does create an alcohol content, but then we have a process where we use a method of distillation that actually removes that alcohol so that we have no alcohol or very little in our kombucha. So I have 3 boys at home, and my kids love to drink our kombucha, and I want to be able to make a kombucha that I can give to my kids.
Now, of course, you could make it into a cocktail with some alcohol, but basically by itself, it's just a mocktail, right?
Yeah, I mean, you can see in these little jars that we've got here, that's what's in the drink, right? So like the Love Kombucha, for instance, is jasmine green tea with lavender, chamomile, and rose petals. And so there's already been a lot of work done to create a great flavor, and that's why I think people really love the variety that we've got.
Can we try one of them?
Let's do it.
Okay, which one should we go for? I feel like this, like, habanero spring one sounds kind of terrifying, but it sounds good.
And well, people can't get that until next week, so we should definitely try it because it'll make you an early guinea pig here for us.
And it'll probably make me awake early in the morning. Not that it's early anymore, but does the habanero kind of give you a kick?
So we partner with a local farm who grows organic habaneros, and so the heat is in there from actual fresh habanero peppers. One thing we don't do is we don't use any artificial flavors or extracts. It's all whole ingredients.
Cheers. Oh my gosh. Ooh.
Right?
What a good. Yeah, not too spicy. Excellent. Yeah. Well, thank you so much. Cheers again, guys. I think you have some in the studio, so we'll cheers back to you.
Yeah,
we
gotta pick your favorite. Yeah, cheers to you. And,
it is correct, Cassidy. We do have some.
Excellent. Which kind are you guys having?
I have mint lemonade. You have what, Drew?
I have mango habanero, and it's a little spicy.
And mine is just happiness. I don't know if that's just the plain one. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Hey, and it pairs very well.
Happiness
with cupcakes.
Is good.
Kombucha and cupcakes this morning. What a way to start the hour, huh?
Thank you, Cassidy.
Cheers.
Thank you, Doctor.